Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. In this episode, I am going to touch on the topic of empty base optimization. This is a relatively deep topic, and things like no unique address will come into play here, and different compilers implement things differently. So this is going to be an introduction to this topic. If you want more information, that'll be your homework. So yes, my name is Jason Turner. I do on-site training. It is the main way that I make a living these days. So be sure to talk to your team and have me out for on-site training, and we can have all of these conversations in person, and we can all learn something together. Let's start with the idea of what even is an empty object. If I return the size of this thing, I am going to get a value greater than zero. Objects must have unique addresses. Now, there are other rules that come into play. If I have a standard layout type, then the element that is first laid out in my struct has the same address as the struct itself. If I have standard layout types with inheritance, the address of the base class object is going to be the same as the address of the derived object. But the general rule here is that objects must have unique addresses. And if you think about this logically, if I have 10 elements of type S, I need some way to be able to index into these things. They must have unique addresses. Data sub 8 must be a different address than data sub 9. So this rule makes sense. I'm going to go ahead and create some new object, and I am going to give it an integer. Now we can reason that the size of this thing is going to be the size of an integer. So it is going to be 4 that is going to be returned here. If I now were to inherit from B, it is reasonable to calculate that the size of S is going to be the size of 2 integers. We're going to have the base class integer B laid out in memory first, and then we'll have the derived class integer J from S laid out next, and we can see that the size of this thing is in fact 8. Empty base optimization is where compilers might do something like this. We know that the size of B is 1, but somehow 1 plus 4 equals 4. The size of this thing is still 4, even though it has inheritance. So this is the empty base optimization idea, and it is where compilers and calling conventions allow us to collapse these things. So if this has multiple inheritance, where it inherits from both B and C, then the size of the thing is still 4. Now, I already said that calling conventions and compilers come into play here, so let's go ahead and switch over to MSVC. We can see that MSVC has made the size of this thing 8. Visual Studio does not do empty base optimization in the same way that GCC and Clang do. The basic idea is that with empty base optimization, base classes are collapsed down if they are empty so that it can optimize object layout. And you can see that Visual Studio does this to some extent, it just doesn't do it with multiple base classes. This is not dependent on optimization level, this has to be a feature of your calling conventions, because if you have two different libraries that are compiled with different optimization flags, they still have to know that the size of S is going to be 4 or 8 or whatever it happens to be, because they need to know how much stack space to set up. And they also need to know what values to put there. Okay, this is where I'm going to end this episode. Like I said, this is an introduction to this topic. So you might want to look at EBO and you might want to look at no unique address from C++ 20, I believe. Thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to subscribe. Leave a comment if you've used EBO in some sort of practical sense in your code.